how to record the monitor output from your console using two different methods, and I don't mean the stage monitors that the musicians are listening to or the main speakers that the audience is listening to. I mean what you are listening to as the mixing engineer. So whether you're using near-field monitors on top of your console or you're using headphones, it's exactly what you're hearing inside your headphones. The first method is a bit quicker but has a slight disadvantage. The second method doesn't have that disadvantage but takes a bit more time to set up. And what I'm about to show you right now is the same exact thing for both methods, so you're gonna need to do it regardless of which method you choose. First thing you're gonna do is go to the monitor section, click on view, and make sure you are in the monitor page. Now if you look here, it says PFL and AFL. PFL stands for pre-fader listening and AFL stands for after fader listening. So by default, if I solo a channel, this signal right here comes straight after the preamp gain, regardless of the fader position. So to fix that, I'm gonna go here and check channel solo AFL. Now the fader position affects the signal. Cool. Same thing goes for the mix buses and for the DCA. So make sure these three are checked, and also go here to the monitor source and set it to left, right, AFL. So it's listening to the whole mix and taking into consideration the position of the main fader. Method number one is to use the USB recorder. Now, before you even plug it in, this is very important. Make sure the format of this is FAT32, not NTFS, not any other weird format, because otherwise the console will simply not recognize it.
Plug the USB stick into your computer, then right-click, format, and under file system, choose FAT32. Now, keep in mind, this will erase everything on the USB stick, so if you have something important, make sure to back it up first, then click start, and that's it.
Next, plug your USB stick into your console and click on view, then you're gonna go to the configuration page, and right here you're gonna see two channels, left and right. To switch between them, do not turn the encoder because this will change the gain, but press on it. Now for the channel left, you're gonna go here, scroll down to monitor slash talkback, and assign monitor left. For the right channel, click here to switch to the right channel, then scroll down and assign to it monitor right. Cool. Now go back to the home page and simply hit record. And when you're done, you're gonna hit stop. And that's it. Something to keep in mind, and this may or may not be a problem to you, and it's that the USB recorder only has 16 bits of dynamic range. In other words, it roughly has 65,000 levels of loudness. In other words, if you are in a very quiet room without any ambient noise whatsoever, and you play this audio at 96 dB SPL or louder, you will start hearing quantization noise. Now, if you don't know what quantization is, I have a short video, I'll link it up here, explaining all the audio fundamentals in a very simple way. And if you work with anything related to audio, I'd highly suggest you watch this video because these are things you should know. Now, if you're okay with 16 bits and it's fine, that's it. Thanks for watching. You can leave. But if you want to record at a higher resolution slash higher bit depth slash bigger dynamic range, you're gonna use the digital audio workstation, whether it's Pro Tools or Ableton Live or Reaper or Tracks Live from Waves or Logic Pro, whatever you prefer. And for the sake of this video, I'm gonna assume that you already know how to connect your mixer to your computer. If not, I've done a bunch of videos showing you how to do that with different DAWs. I'll link them down in the description.
I'm gonna create a new track and call it monitor, then assign the input of that track to the last two outputs of the cards from the mixer, so 31 and 32, and the output of that track to anything because I don't need to hear it for now. Then hit record and start recording.
A few things I need to mention before I show you what to do on the console, and it's that yes, you can do multi-track recording and record the monitor output at the same time as long as you do the proper routing. However, if you want to record all 32 channels, you cannot do that. You can use all 32 channels, but you need to have two spare outputs to use for the monitor recording. So you can record 30 of these channels and the last two will be for the monitor. Another thing, if you decide to record at 24 bits or 32-bit floating point, yes, it's of course better than the USB recorder, which is 16 bits. However, you will not benefit from 32 bits because if you clip the monitor signal inside the console or the solo bus if you clip it inside the console, it will arrive clipped to your computer, so you're not going to be able to recover it. Okay, so there's no additional benefit to using 32 bits as opposed to 24 bits. Oh, and in case you need to record all 32 channels, you're gonna need to use the first method, which is the USB recorder. That's the only option.
Next, go to routing and then go to the card page. And I like to do this on the last two outputs. So I'll choose the last block of 8 channels and go down till I see auxiliary aux 1 to 6/monitor and select that. And here you can see monitor left and monitor right are assigned to the last two channels. However, if you do this, you cannot record channels 25 to 30. If you're okay with that, you can just use that. Or if you want to record these channels, you can go down and choose user out 25 to 32. And then go all the way to the right to the user page and then assign output 31 to monitor right here, monitor left, and then output 32 to monitor right. And then you can assign the channels 25 to 30 to whatever you want, really. Then hit record and start recording.